Oh, man. I love haunted houses. What I don't love is the escape the room challenge. Does anybody know what this is? Okay, for anybody who doesn't, it's something you do with like five people you want to like hang out with but also not talk to or like after the event. And basically, they drop you off in a warehouse somewhere and they're like, it's a dungeon or whatever, but you can only leave if you like do a Rubik's Cube and eat a cockroach or something. I don't exactly know how it works. But I realized recently why I have no interest in the Escape the Room challenge. I have depression. So every day is already an Escape the Room challenge. I wake up every morning and I just hear a pre-recorded voice in my head just like, good morning. You live on a futon. There's Cheeto dust on everything. You're chasing a dream that like for sure won't come true. And now we offer you this chilling challenge to find a way out. And then you're like, oh, I found a way out. But you do the way out across instead of up. And then you got to go to the special hospital for sad boys for 3 days. All right. Some of you got real clammy on that suicide joke, and you're going to need to strap the fuck in right now. I, as I said, have depression, which, as it turns out, by the way, is super trendy right now. It is. Bummers are the new black. When was the last time you met somebody under 30 that didn't have, like, a debilitating mental disorder? It doesn't happen. I met somebody who wasn't crazy the other day. It was like talking to someone without a Facebook. I was just like, but what do you do? Like, what? When are you sad? Why does cry? Like, I don't understand. And I'm going to tell you guys something, and I just want nobody to get worried. Nobody needs to call anyone. It's going to be fine. I think about suicide, I would say 5 to 10 times a week. And some of you are looking at me like you have never thought of killing yourself. And first of all, good for you. And second of all, I don't trust you. Like, what do you know that I don't, motherfucker? Because we're both out there in this blood-soaked nightmare, and you're like, oh, well, this seems fine. You're a sociopath. There is something wrong with you. I found out recently that the word suicide is a lot like the N-word. You can think it, you can say it among very close circles of friends, but if you just write it willy-nilly on Facebook, boy oh boy are you going to get some phone calls. I got a call from a friend of mine who like just was livid that I would even think of killing myself, and he's like, bro, no! And I'm like, yeah, but bro, maybe. And he spends like 20 minutes giving me this pep talk, and then he hits a line that I had to stop him at because he goes, I just don't know how anybody could ever kill themselves because all human life is precious. And I was like, let's pump the brakes on that for a second. Some human life is precious. A lot of human life is just kind of around. Now, I'm not saying it shouldn't be. It needs to be here. We need parsley on the plate because it makes the steak look awesome. Like, I understand the concept. But if a million people check out tomorrow, we don't lose a million snowflakes. We lose, like, two Hitlers, a Gandhi, and then a lot of people that work at the bank. Like, that's...